Today, I'll show you how to use Miro, a giant digital whiteboard that helps you turn ideas into action with your team, no matter where they are in the world. Now, by the end of this video, you'll know how to conduct your first all-digital team brainstorming session, use templates to avoid wasting time in your meetings, build flowcharts and diagrams with wicked speed with AI, and actually have some fun driving agreement with your team. Now to access Miro, click the card at the top or use the link in the description. Let's dive in. From the homepage, click on the big purple button that says sign up free. Then enter your work email and click on the continue with email button. Miro then sends a sign-in link to that email. Once you click the link, get through the next 5 questions, skip inviting your teammates, yes, we're sure about that one, and I'll take you through templates. So let's select, I want to start from scratch. And here we are in our first board, and Miro has asked us about templates again. They are very useful, but we are going to start from scratch. Click the X in the top right. Now we're in our first board. Let me show you around. On the left side of the screen, you can use the tools in this toolbar to add all sorts of content to the board. In the top left, you can change the name of your board, you can change the board thumbnail, and you can access and change board settings. In the top right, you can add reactions, review activities with your team, or even record yourself walking through a board with a talk track. You can also share this board with your teammates. Finally, you can zoom in and out with the controls in the bottom right, and you can also access the Help Center. That's enough orientation. Let's clean this up and get started on your first team brainstorming session. Now, we're planning an event called the Community Hub to bring people together to be inspired, connect with each other, and have a great time. This is our vision, and I created this by dragging and dropping a file from my computer into my Miro board. Now, let's create our brainstorming space. If you use a mouse, right-click and drag to move the board around. If you use a trackpad, you can move around using 2 fingers on the trackpad. Let's add some text. Click on the giant T icon in the left toolbar. Then click on the left side of the canvas to insert some text. The text toolbar shows up and we need to make some adjustments. First, the size. Let's turn this up to 48 and let's make it bold. Click on the font style button and then click on the B. And now we can just type keynote speakers. Click on the board so the text loses focus. You can click on it to select it again, and you can click on it again to edit it. Unselect it again by clicking on the board. You can move the text by clicking and dragging it. We need to add a few more pieces of text, so right-click on it, then select copy. Then right-click anywhere on the board, and select paste at the top. You may need to allow Miro to see text and images copied to the clipboard first. You can also use the familiar keyboard shortcuts of Ctrl-C and Ctrl-V. Let's paste another. Now I want to organize this text. You can select multiple by clicking on the board and dragging. You can add to the selection by holding the shift key and then clicking on another element. Let's add the last one too. I want all of these to be aligned left and distributed evenly. To make that happen, click on the Align Objects button in the toolbar. Then click on the Align Left icon. Click on Align Objects again, then click on the Distribute Vertically icon. Finally, click and drag these underneath the image above. Next, I'll change each of these pieces of text to represent things we need to brainstorm. Let me fill out the rest of them quickly. Let's also zoom in using the mouse wheel or spreading your fingers apart on the trackpad. Next, let's add some lines between these categories. Click on the Shapes button in the toolbar, then click on the simple line in the top left. Then click and drag anywhere on the board to draw your line. The line isn't quite straight. You can click and drag one end, and then while still holding down the mouse button, hold the shift key to make it straight. Click on the line type button in order to change the thickness of the line. Use the scale to make it an appropriate thickness. Next, I'll quickly copy and paste these lines in between each category. Now we can start brainstorming some ideas. Click on the sticky notes button in the left toolbar, then choose your color. Place the sticky note on the board and start typing. And great, you've just added your first idea to your Miro board. Congratulations. But it's a bit lonely to brainstorm by yourself. So let's share this with some coworkers by clicking on the share button in the top right. I'll add 2 people from my team. The first is Adele and the other is Patty. Click send invitations and then Miro asks you a smart question that you probably haven't thought of. What should they see when they come into the board? I'm happy with the defaults, so let's click done. And after they accept the invite, we see that both Patty and Adele are in the board. And if we zoom in here, we can see that Adele is adding her own sticky note. Let's see who she suggests as a keynote speaker. Ah, of course, we gotta have Kevin, don't we? And looks like Patty has a suggestion too. Mark Rober. All right, cool. Let's keep the brainstorming going and we'll see you in just a bit. Now we just finished and I want to give you a quick tip to optimize your team sessions in Miro. You and any of your teammates can move anything on the board. That includes things you may not want them moving. In order to maintain order, you can lock specific items in place by selecting them and then clicking on the lock icon. This way, they can't be selected and so they can't be moved by mistake. Now let's take these sticky notes and turn them into a plan. There are all sorts of widgets you can add to a Miro board, and you can find them by clicking on the plus icon in the left sidebar. We'll add a table to our board. Let's zoom out a bit first and then put the table to the left. In Miro, a table is by default used for project plans or tasks, but you can change the columns here to whatever you like. Now here's the cool part. If each of these sticky notes represents a task to follow up on, then we can select all of them and just drag and drop them onto the table. If we go back to the table, we see all these tasks have now been added. And now you can add extra properties like the description, status, and so on. If you wanted to add a time frame to these tasks, then you can change the view by clicking on the table icon and then selecting timeline. Here you can drag the time frames for each task until you have an overall project plan. Before we wrap up, let me teach you one more thing about good board hygiene. First, let's organize our work. We'll move the table back to the side and then the sticky notes back to their original positions. Hopefully Kevin's gonna sponsor us here. The last thing we do to organize is to put a frame around our content. A frame allows us to logically group parts of the board. You can use one of these templates, or you can just click and drag around all the elements you want to include. And now you can move this entire frame around separately. Congratulations, you've gotten through the main part of the tutorial. Now I'm going to show you three ways to enhance your team's experience, starting with templates. So let's click on the templates icon in the left sidebar. Let's envision we're creating a customer journey map. This helps us understand the experience of someone attending our event. It's easy to search by typing in your desired outcome and then pressing enter. There are a ton of options to choose from. Let's choose this one from Hanan. This gives us a way to jumpstart our meeting without having to create all of this scaffolding ourselves. Now, this template is fun for a few reasons. It encourages you to have fun with visuals over text. For example, instead of typing a feeling name, you can drag and drop that emoji onto the chart. And I just copy that image, by the way, by holding the Alt key while dragging. You can add other stickers too by clicking on the stickers, emoji, and GIFs icon in the left toolbar. So let's add a little thumbs up. Click on the emoji and then click on the board. Click the board again to exit the panel. Now look, we've got a new comment on the board. You can see it by putting your mouse over the comment circle. Then you can click on the circle if you want to reply. To add your own comment, click on the board, then press the C key on your keyboard. This now turns your cursor into a comment box, and you can click anywhere on the board to add a comment. Type your comment and press enter to submit it. Templates, stickers, and comments will really help, but what about workflows and diagrams? When you have a diagramming tool, you want to make some diagrams. So let me show you how. First, let's get rid of our comment cursor by clicking on the pointer icon. Now you can create a diagram by clicking on the plus icon and then searching for a diagram. This way you can drag shapes out one by one and create your diagram. But I'm going to show you something different, which can be really fast. We'll click on the star icon in the top left to create with AI. Now you can generate sticky notes, documents, images, or diagrams. Now to create that diagram, you need to create a prompt. That prompt is a set of instructions that tells Miro AI what to do. Here's a prompt for us to look at. Basically, create a flowchart that helps us plan this from start to finish. Click generate diagram and watch the magic happen. Here's our flowchart. Let's exit out of create with AI to see more of it. As you scan this, you probably notice two things. Does it have some quirks? Yes. Is it faster than creating it from scratch? Also, yes. Now our board is getting quite extensive. But there's one last thing that we need to cover. You've brainstormed all these ideas, and now you need to drive agreement. Here are some tools to help. Click this Tools and Reactions icon in the top right toolbar. Then click on Voting. You're going to be asked to upgrade. There is a free trial available, so that's what I'm going to sign up for. I'll see you back on this page in just a sec. We're back in the Tools menu, so let's click on Voting one more time. Now we're trying to get the team to vote on who should do the catering. First, let's change the voting area to just the catering options. All the purple circles indicate items we can vote for, but we're not voting for text, so let's filter it out. Click on the checkbox next to sticky notes. Next, you can change how many votes each person gets and how much time they get to vote. Now, voting starts when you click start. Everyone is then shown this dialogue and gets the chance to join voting by clicking join voting. Here you can choose up to two items, so I'll click these two and then say, I'm done. I'm now waiting for the rest of the team to cast their votes. Adele and Patty have just voted, so we can check the results by clicking on the voting icon. We can see that all three members of the team have voted, so let's click end for all, and then end session. And easy enough, we see the winner is Grill on Wheels. Now, voting is just one of many team activities available in Miro. To find others, click on the plus menu once again, and let's scroll down to the section called Collaboration. Check out some of these tools. The alignment scale asks a single question, and then everyone has to put their answer somewhere visually on the scale. Breakout frames is like breakout rooms in Zoom. You give each person or subteam their own frame to play in. They have some questions that they need to answer in that frame, and then after a certain time limit, everyone comes back to the main board. The rest of these are self-explanatory, and I gotta tell you, the spinner wheel is a great way to have some fun on a Friday afternoon.
Well, they say teamwork makes the dream work, and Miro makes it work even when your team's still dreaming in another time zone. Huh? You know, I'm glad I didn't pick up comedy.